Today we will try to understand conduction current density. Now there are different kinds of current densities and they depend on how the current is produced. For example, there is conduction current density, convection current density, displacement current density, polarization current density and magnetization current density. Today we shall try to understand this conduction current density. This conduction current density. Now let us see the definition. Current density is defined as the current passing through the unit surface area of an imaginary surface held normal to the direction of flow of current. And here we are talking about this conduction current density. The current density defined as the current which is passing through a unit surface area, which is passing through a unit surface area of an imaginary surface. Held normal to the direction of flow of the current. Now, then what should be its magnitude? From here, the current density is the current which is passing through a unit surface area. Therefore, the magnitude we can write as J, modulus J, that is J, and we are showing this current density by the symbol J vector. It's a vector quantity, so we are showing it as by this vector J, and its magnitude is J, capital J, and by definition that is I by S, where I is the current flowing through the conductor of surface area S, where I is the current flowing through a conductor of surface area S. Now, what is the unit of J? SI unit, it is ampere per meter square. Now, what is the direction of J? The direction of J is taken as the direction of the flow of current. That is, the direction of current density will be along the direction of the flow of current. Now next we shall see the relation between current I and the current density j. For this, we consider a surface having surface area S. And let I be the current flowing through this surface. And we know that the direction of current density will be along the direction of the flow of current. So we shall see two cases, case 1 or case A. Now here in this case, the current is flowing in a direction which will be perpendicular to the surface S. Now let us draw the surface. Now here in this case, we consider current I flowing in a direction, perpendicular to the surface S, This is surface S we are talking about. And here, this is the normal or perpendicular direction to this surface S, and we know that the direction of the area vector is the normal to the plane of the area. If this is the area, so the direction will be perpendicular or normal to this surface. And here we are considering a surface ds, and so the normal of this surface is along this direction, and this is the direction of the area according to the convention. Now in this case, the direction of the current density is along the direction of the normal to this plane, that is perpendicular to this surface. That means the direction of the current density is along the direction of the area vector. That is, if this is the ds, then the area vector has direction along this normal, and here we have taken A as the normal vector, unit normal vector perpendicular to S, and this is the direction or the unit vector along the direction of the area. So the current density can be written as J. We can write it as J equal to magnitude of J and An, where An is the unit vector perpendicular or normal to the surface S. And J is the magnitude of this, the current density vector, right? Now we consider a differential area, this ds, and it is expressed as in vector form. Ds is equal to its magnitude and the direction of the unit vector. This is a convention. Whenever we take area, the direction is, if the direction of that area is perpendicular to the its plane, we can write it as, since the direction of area vector is taken as the direction perpendicular to the surface. Now in this case, the differential current, let us differential current dI is flowing through this surface dS, and it will be given by the product of this J and the elementary surface or differential surface, magnitude of the differential surface dS. So dI in this case, that is the differential current, is equal to J dS. That is magnitude of J and magnitude of this vector dS. And we have to find the total current, then we have to integrate this one. Just simply we have to integrate this one and we will get the total current flowing through this whole surface S when this direction of J is along the direction of the area vector. This is I, and I is along the direction of the area vector. Now this is case B. Here in this case, the current is flowing at an angle theta to this surface S. Now we have considered again elementary surface or differential surface dS here, and the current density, as the current density is along the direction of the current, it is making an angle theta with this the area vector, that is the direction of the area. As again it can be stated that the direction of area is the direction along the normal or perpendicular to the surface. So here the differential current which is flowing through this differential surface or the elementary surface dS, this surface dS is given by dI, and dI will be equal to the component of J. The component here, we can see this is the direction of J here, and the component, this is the direction of J here, the component of J along the direction of the area, that is in this direction, in along the direction normal to the surface, this direction. It is making angle theta, so the component of this J along the direction of the area, that is along the direction normal to the surface, this surface dS, is J cos theta. So dI will be component of J along dS, along dS, and multiplied by dS, the magnitude of dS. Now what is the component of J along dS? The component of J along dS, this is the direction of dS, is J cos theta, as J is making an angle theta with the direction of the area, this elementary area or the differential area dS. So it is J cos theta dS, and we can write it in vector form as J, or in dot product form as J dot dS, since we know that J dot dS is J dS cos theta, J dS cos theta. Therefore, if we have to find out the total current I through this surface S, total current I through this surface S, then I simply we have to integrate this equation 1. So left hand side is I, and the right hand side is J dot dS. So the total current is given by I equal to integral J dot ds. Now this is the relation between current and the current density. Now if the surface is a closed surface, that is if the surface encloses a volume, that is it encloses a volume, I is equal to J dot ds integrated over that closed surface S. Here this symbol is the symbol for closed surface integral. So this was all about conduction current density.